not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. And Romans 8:28-30 reads, and we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. For those God foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those whom he predestined, he also called. Those he called, he also justified. Those he justified, he also glorified. These are our announcements for today. This afternoon, Beth will continue the celebration of Pastor Gillette's 46th anniversary service. The time is 2:45 p.m. Dr. Kevin B. Hall and the St. John Baptist Church of Richmond will be our guests. Attention ushers, you are scheduled to meet this Tuesday, March 14th at 6:30 p.m. And the youth and young adult ministry will meet on Friday, March 17th, 2017 at 6:30 p.m. And the deacons and deaconess are asked to meet on Saturday, March 18th at 11 a.m. in the D.B. Bell Conference Room. The church membership register is being updated. If you have changed your contact information, such as phone number or address, please send all changes to the church clerk at jones.jane@att.net, or the information can be placed in the church mailbox in the church office. Thank you for listening, and have a blessed day.
Get up and do it twice. Also, for your information, those of you that will be staying, I understand that they will be providing some light refreshments after the morning service. I see Brother Christian in the audience, and I won't say no more about that. Thank all of you all for what you've done during this period of celebration. As I mentioned to you before, it's not so much the money, but your presence means a lot.
Thank you. does not really have to campaign. Because all year she is at the forefront of helping people locally and fighting in, is there a place called DC? I got to know her very well after the last earthquake. The mayor, L.A.U. Harris, appointed us as co-workers of a committee which examined needs of individuals who were especially hurt and needed financial help. And then during the last 5 or 6 years of her mother's life, we lived in the same complex. So I saw the Honorable Congresswoman several times. And I have to admit, I was jealous of your mother. Because anything that could be done on a cell phone, your mother could do it. But we are glad to have you, and she belongs to a very small church in East Oakland.
Pastor James, members of the clergy to this great choir, my brothers and sisters, Mayor Sharp, Councilmember McElhaney, Peggy, so good to see you. I just have to first say to all of you what a wonderful team we have in this great city. Congregation, 46 years of community service,
46 years of demonstrating, this is what the book of James tells us, faith without works is dead. Faith without works. You have inspired us, Pastor James. You've inspired this community, this congregation, and me personally to remember that as we pray, we must do the work that God requires us to do, to feed the hungry, to house the homeless, to shelter those who need care, to visit those who are sick, and those in prison. And so as you embark upon this next chapter of your life, I just wanted to once again say how much I appreciate you and present to you my congressional record statement, which I went to the floor of Congress, and we, and yes, D.C. is pretty ridiculous right now. Not a lot is getting done, but sometimes I get a chance to do something that makes sense. And so I went to the floor of Congress, and I said, Mr. Speaker, I rise today to honor a great religious, spiritual, and civic leader, Pastor Gillette James of Beth, Baptist Church. As he retires after more than 46 years of faithful service to his community. I'm not going to read the entire congressional record because we've put the life and legacy of great people in the history, historical records of the United States. But I did say, Pastor James is truly an inspiration to other aspiring clergy, helping 42 other members complete coursework at accredited seminaries during his tenure. And 12 of those received advanced degrees. His leadership has been invaluable to those who have worked under his guidance to achieve their dreams of becoming ministers themselves. On behalf of California's 13th Congressional District, I take great pride in joining the Beth Eden community to salute the extraordinary Gillette James as he retires as pastor of Beth Eden Baptist Church. I appreciate him for his 46 years of service and wish him many years of joyful retirement. God bless you.
Really needed now. Praise God. Whereas Dr. Gillette James has supported Oakland's youth by sitting on Bethany Baptist Church's scholarship committee, which has supported numerous individuals to attain an education. And whereas Dr. Gillette James has proudly defended women in ministry. Church to embrace people with different viewpoints and ethnic backgrounds. And now, therefore, be it proclaimed that today, March 4th, 2020—this was from the other day. We already had the day, but we're going to celebrate it again. That today is Dr. Gillette O. James Day in the city of Portland.
Yeah. come so far by faith, leaning on the Lord.
Yes.
Through all, we like to trust in God. We like to trust. To the clergyman, headed by Pastor James, deacons and deaconesses, ushers, choir, members of this great church at Eden, visitors, the committee responsible for this program, you were entrusted to carry out, to plan, and to also execute. I bring you greetings from family members in Rhode Island and my church, and members from Liberia, West Africa.
All right.
To the grace of God and His healing mercy, I'm privileged. To be here to participate in this historic and yet spiritual and accomplished celebration. 1971, as a student at San Francisco State University, as I was living with my sister, my late sister, Martha Minor, sponsored me to come to America. I met a couple, my neighbors, Deacon Johnny Gibson and his wife Coral Gibson. Under their guidance, they brought me and Isetta Chesson to this church. We were warmly greeted and given moral, educational, and financial support. I continued to remain a member of this church and kept in touch, and the church kept in touch with me. This celebration would not have been today if Pastor James and Sister Sister James had not taken the responsibility to carry out the charge. I will say here that to the James family, the Ferguson family, Ron Mahammon family, King spoke from the island, and all of us. I know that it is, as you would say, it's a little bit melancholy or also worrying, a little bit depressing. But just remember the memories of Jennifer. Jennifer, you remember when and confidently recited the church covenant. Well, you remember when you gave your trial sermon? Pastor James, you remember, of course, when you read in the inquiry in the newspaper and saw the name, and you sought out to find Sister Rosa. At the Y, the cafeteria, the library. That was a commitment day. But more so, in 1958, verses 12, verses 19 to 20. You took that lesson, that charge. And today we celebrate 46 years.
Amen.
You came here, maybe with an obstacle and an opposition, but you are determined. And you came here with administrative skills and other skills like musical skill, clerical skill, play the piano and all kinds of type. The journalism, the radio, broadcasting, you have all those. But yet, you were an established pastor of Union Newton and then Grace Baptist Church. You are not certified. Why? Because you were licensed to carry out the Great Commission. And so to this day, as you lead Beth in a Baptist church, you say, I'm pressing higher and more. But more so, you also say, in Isaac Newton's voice, and your book, not Isaac Newton, but John Newton, and your two toilers and snares, you've already come. So you will stand on that Christ the solid rock.
Yes.
No other ground but sinking. Thank you for having sponsored me in some way and my two sons to walk.